What is up, Roll Gamers, and welcome to the new minor Let's Play, as I promised, with Albania, Bangladesh, part one. Don't know what the title, just like Albania. I'm just gonna keep it as it is for Albania, Albanian Kingdom. Somebody did say Albanian Empire, but I'll just stick with Kingdom since I overuse Empire a lot. But anyways, yes, Bangladesh has finally started, and as promised, I was gonna start this Let's Play included with Albania once I was done with both Honduras and Romania, and I completed them weeks ago. I need a thumbnail for my photo thing on YouTube, so let me do a thumbnail right now. That's my thumbnail right there. So yes, every time I'm gonna be doing that now on video, trying to get a thumbnail because I want to add my face cam or a photo of my face cam onto the thumbnail of my video. So it's gonna be weird, but hey, gotta do the thumbnail now, guys, since again the face cam is here and you guys are watching me, my every move, 24/7. So Bangladesh, I've played Bangladesh numerous of times for Versus, and of course a lot of viewers and supporters and subscribers, all of the above, are from Bangladesh and nearby India included. So again, thank you to my viewers and fans from that region. I appreciate it so much that you guys love my videos and love it every time I play as Bangladesh, not just in the Supreme Ruler, but also in Hearts of Iron and maybe even in Europa in the future as well. So again, guys, thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. I can't say this enough, and that's the best I can do. Just keep saying it, just to let you guys know that I do really appreciate all the support and love that you guys are giving me, and that I give back to you guys, the Upworld Gamers, as well from all around the world. And I haven't forgotten about India as well. Getting a lot of supporters from there and subscribers. India versus China will happen once I'm done with the big major versus that I still haven't even finished yet. I completely forgot about it. I might have to stream it maybe, which is Russia versus USA. I'm almost there towards the East Coast. I'm somewhere around, I think, Illinois, Wisconsin. I think I'm going to just send all of my units towards the state of New York and just head southward towards DC and just hopefully eliminate the U.S. from there. I might have to build more units back in Seattle for Russia. So, yeah, once I'm done with that, India versus China, another big major versus will happen. And then I've got more as well. Russia versus China, USA versus China, Russia versus Europe, etc., etc. So I haven't forgotten about those big versus, which are very important. All right, so as always, every time I start a minor or major Let's Play, I build a military, not like Versus. In Versus, I just use whatever the nation has in their arsenal and their reserves. But in Let's Plays, any Let's Plays, I build my military. I don't know how to in, what is it, Hearts of Iron Europa, sadly. But in Supreme Ruler, of course, I've always played it, so I know I'm good. I've built my military, navy, air, and land. Land, air, and sea. Got a total of 191 land units. Most of these designs, though, are the FRES, the Future Rapid Effects System vehicle, which is my favorite unit design of all. I'm using the Indian Arjun Mark I tank and also the British Vickers Mark V tank as well in there. And for anti-tank, I'm using a German Trigat. That's it for land vehicles. Artillery, also Indian design. The Navy, I'm using an Indian destroyer here, the Delhi, and then of course some other frigates and patrol ships in there. And then finally, as for the air units, I also have transportation ships. I forgot to state the goal in the beginning, actually, and I forgot to start the timer. Idiot me. Baka, baka. The goal of Bangladesh, actually, is to enact several neighboring nations. Now, something looks weird, something looks odd here in our borders with Bangladesh, me, and West India. This is also in the mod called Divided Planet, which is one of my favorite mods in Suprema 2020. Ultimate doesn't have it included. And I wanted to do one Let's Play in Ultimate and one in 2020 in Bangladesh. Feels a lot more better in 2020 than Ultimate, since again Ultimate has problems with FPS and frame rate issues It's just not stable, unlike in 2020. So Bangladesh I chose for 2020 instead of Ultimate. But anyways, West India actually kind of kicked off the war against me. They declared war and kind of took a couple of towns and cities. I did make a peace treaty with them. I signed an embassy treaty as well, just in case, and a non-aggression pact for the heck of it, because I wanted to build my military. And I know that I built a bunch of stuff. As you can see, Bangladesh right now is kind of clustered in with a bunch of factories, agriculture facilities, fabrications, etc., etc. So yeah, I kind of clustered your countries, your country basically. But in the plus side, the economy has went up, money has gone up, population has also gone up to 137 million. Immigration, 1.9 million. Emigration, 133,000. Literacy, 91%. Tourism is at 51% high, very high. We are winning a lot there in the economic area. What else? Check here in the stats. As you can see, already, or that was because of West India. I only got one unit kill from them. 182,000 total army staff. I'm already in the top of the leaderboards with a nice military, but West India still up ahead right there with 201,000. And then again, the economy, poll ranking number 3 right now for Bangladesh. Sao Tome and Principe and Swaziland, African nations, are just the ones ahead of me. And then finally, my GDP. My GDP is at 5,600. When you start off with Bangladesh, I think the GDP is like at around 2100 or 2200. Now it's at 5,600. And again, our population, our tourism, our literacy, our health, our lifestyle is going up. Everything for Bangladesh is going great right now, 100%. And we go over here from the bottom. Now we're somewhere midway, right ahead of Sao Tome and right behind Ecuador and also Northern China. So I'm a good leader. Adept is leading Bangladesh to a healthy lifestyle, to a better economic divergence. It's a new apex, man. It's a new Bangladesh now that I've created here, military wise, economic wise, health wise, everything. Even though there might be more pollution now because all these facilities, factories, etc., etc., yo, everything is going good for Bangladesh, and you guys should be happy that our money, GDP, military, etc., etc., is at an all-time high. So I was busy doing all that, and again, total of 293 units ready for war. I forgot to point out the air units. I've built some Russian floggers, Falcrums, and then some American, had to include an American design there, the American multi-fighter F-16C Falcon. I love the F-16 Falcon, so I built that. And then finally, to top it off, Hind helicopters from Russia as well. So yeah, this is Divided Planet. Again, my goal is to annex West India, because again, they started the war. Everyone, especially you viewers from Bangladesh, my supporters from there, should be ecstatic and angry and frustrated that West India out of nowhere declared war and took 3 towns. As you can see, this belongs to Bangladesh. Boom, some land there. And then they also took some of my ore mine factories, the only ones I built, and a major city, Sylhet. So we're gonna have to annex West India here. And then again, once I'm done annexing them, I'm also gonna annex Nepal, Bhutan, Tibet, of course, Myanmar, aka Burma, Sri Lanka. I might have to annex them. I want an island under my control as well. And then to top it off, Pakistan, I think, might be my last nation. We'll see how far this Let's Play goes and how long it takes. Again, it depends, guys, on how my schedule is with work, sleep, and also anime. Because, you know, anime is always got to be included there. And most importantly, my other Let's Plays versus streams and games that I have currently going on right now. So we'll see. And then I was also deciding on invading one Middle Eastern country, that being Qatar. I just want to have a little enclave over there in the Gulf, which that being Qatar. So that's why I made an alliance with Saudi Arabia. And I do have a lot of alliances, as you can see, from Southeastern Asia, all around the Middle East and Asia, etc., etc. I wanted to have a bunch of alliances just because, again, why not? I'm going to be annexing just my neighbor nations here. So that's the overview right there. I know it was a long overview, but I just had to give you guys a long overview because, again, Bangladesh viewers, gotta explain everything to you because you love me. I love you guys. You support me. Thank you so much. And again, if you want to support me even more, patron link below. Again, $1, $5, $10 rank tiers. Recruit, regular, plus more rank tiers coming soon with more rewards. Whatever, guys. Again, your versus or let's play can be moved to the top of the queue in one of those rewards. I think it's the $5, $10 option. I'm not sure. And Friday will be Empire Fridays. Again, you can get more chances as well if you support me on Patreon, showing me your saves, your empires in Supreme Ruler, Hearts of Iron, and Europa 4. So, got that going. And Patreon Joel Lefik, I'll let you know in a message, Steam, YouTube, wherever, when I'll be streaming. Probably tomorrow. Again, I'll be announcing that tomorrow if I can, because Wednesday I don't upload a video. Wednesday's my midweek off, so I might stream tomorrow. A short one, though. Without further ado, let's get this show on the road, baby. All right. West India. I was actually kind of pissed, actually. I felt that, man. When they declared war, it came out of nowhere. Like, I wasn't expecting West India. I was expecting, you know, Burma to declare a war, but my neighbor, West India, declared a war. And out of all the Indian states, actually, I had the worst relations with West India. I had some average relations, some good relations with places like Kashmir, Punjab, and Rajasthan. But West India was the only one that didn't really like me at all, so I had to improvise attack them now with the mighty military that I have built now. So, again, these units that I've built, mostly the FRES infantry vehicles, should get the job done mostly. I have no idea why my naval ships are retreating back to the port. I mean, guys, there's no reason to retreat, you know? We're pushing in right now. BTR 60, again, those obsolete units. 19 unit kills, 3 unit losses so far. And West India is sending more tanks down over here. Yep. Gotta stop. There we go. So I'm probably gonna take Metropolis City of Rajpur first and then take the capital city of Kolkata. I don't want to deal with the other two, three major cities right there. So I'm just gonna head straight south here and then just attack Kolkata from there. All right, then we're gonna attack Kolkata here, and we're also gonna bring some more backup because they're trying to take that city. Get out of here, West India. You chose the wrong country to mess with right now. Now that Arab is in control, I'm the leader here. I'm the boss, man. Made the wrong choice, damn it. Giving back my territory. Give me everything, though.
We need reinforcements.
And there we have it. West India has been annexed. And actually, I still got like 3-4 minutes left. Let's annex one more nation, that being the peaceful, small, neutral country of Bhutan. They're at war with another northern China. I'm just gonna annex Bhutan because why not? West India is under my control. I border them right there to the north. And then again, Tibet, which will probably be my next target to be annexed. I've got an alliance with one Chinese state being Uyghuristan, since there's a healthy bunch of Muslim population living there, just like in Bangladesh. Alright, so we got that going for us. Again, I won't be going further deep into the Indian states. I do not want to annex them. As you can see, that's going to be a long road. India has a bunch of rivers, cities, towns, and also a decent-sized large military. So I do not want to deal with the rest of the Indian states. And Pakistan might be my choice later on. Maybe. Maybe. All right. So I might let you guys decide, actually, for Pakistan. maybe in a poll on Patreon, exclusively to Patreon. Again, you can support me there, or you can get the access, or on YouTube, wherever. We'll see, guys. I just got a bunch of stuff and crap to do. Everything's full right now for me, so I gotta repair some of these obsolete vehicles that need it.
Yep.
Again, these tanks are not one of the best. The British Vickers and the Indian Arjun tank, they're not one of the best. Comparing it to like the Israeli Merkava, the British Challenger, or even the, I guess you can say the Russian T-80 maybe. It's not one of the best designs, but again, I want to stay true since we're here in Central Asia, India, and whatnot. So I built mostly the Arjun tank. Southern China. Oh, I can make a peace treaty with them. Sweet. I'll just give them $4.1 billion. The hell with it. I've got enough money. I'm almost to $1 trillion. Bangladesh should be proud of that as well. You are almost to $1 trillion. But now that we have annexed and declared war on someone, our GDP has gone down. Sadly, everything has gone down for us. Nobody likes us. Tourism has gone down. So that kind of messes the thing up now. The golden age of Bangladesh is about to go down because, again, I'm going to declare war on a bunch of nations and annex them, and their economy is going to get swallowed up as well. All right, so let's get a move on here. Again, repair most of these obsolete vehicles and units. The heck, dude? Jeez, these are really, really bad. Gosh. And I can also move garrisons, that's right. You can move your garrisons wherever you want, so that's kind of a problem. That means they'll be open for attack, or that city will be open for attack, since I move them every single time. I don't want that. Guys, you can subscribe if you want. A lot more videos for Bangladesh coming soon, and also the other Let's Plays and games. So what I'm going to do right now is actually just head straight for Bhutan, because I've got like 10 seconds now. Screw it. Let's just send just 70 units. Fresh water by the DR Congo, I'll accept. But yeah. Again, I apologize for clustering your countries, guys. But again, we have to get that economy working there. We have to get our military working. I didn't want to see no 2,000 GDP. I don't want to see no military of, I think, like, how did it start? Like 20,000, 30,000 to start? Nah, I want to see that. At 300,000, we're close there now. Close. Can I get there? I cannot get to Bhutan. Fucking hell. Alright. Desperate calls for desperate measures. Actually, I'm not gonna give you that much. I'll just give you $742 million. We'll put another 3 minutes in the video here. Alright, we'll wait for this whole transit treaty with Tibet because I cannot enter. As you can see, I did build a bunch of roads. By the way, I forgot to point this out. Roads, bridges connecting everywhere for Bangladesh. Just gotta watch out for the floodings and whatnot, and earthquakes, and landslides, etc., etc. But there's no roads connecting up here since I belong to West India, so gotta improvise here, make a strategic call, and build, or not build, but make a full transit treaty with Tibet. So that is what I'll do, because I'm going to invade Bhutan right here, right now. This is going to hurt my economy and my people's approval rating. I am sorry. I really wish I can keep everything as it was. Again, the golden age, everything peaceful. But for the viewers, for the Let's Play, it must happen. Oh, yeah. Sorry. Oh, I'm going to get a lot of hate. For some reason, I get, or that was back then when I did Nepal versus Bhutan, I think, but, or Bhutan versus India and China, I think that's what it was. I remember a lot of people, or Bhutan viewers, a few of them disapproved of my video, since Bhutan is a peaceful, neutral country, and they're really not involved at all, and they really don't have a military at all. But, again, I just annexed them for a second, or whatever time this was, or whatever, how many times I did. Yes. Belong to me, Bangladesh. There you go. I'm gonna save it. Dang it. Whatever. And Bhutan and West India have been annexed, and now Bangladesh has its own little empire, or kingdom, I should say now. Dominion of Bangladesh, if we can call it that. It used to be called Dominion of Pakistan, I remember that. Now, we can call it actually, maybe Dominion of Bangladesh, so that might be a front runner for the title of this Let's Play, guys. So, my next target, actually, Nepal will probably be on hold. Or not Nepal, Tibet, since I'm at war with southern China now, or not anymore. Damn it. Fuck, I should have done something before. But I think I might just go to war against Nepal in the next part, part two. So again, guys, tomorrow, again, is my midweek off. No YouTube video, as always. If I do stream, I'll post an announcement on YouTube, Patreon, and Twitch, and also Twitter to let you guys know. All links below. You can support me on Patreon as well if you want. Thank you so much again for the people that are currently and have been supporting me for a long time, Illinois Mapping, and also Jose Pena. But it means a lot when a lot of people or more people support me on Patreon. It means that I am really supported and I am really loved around the world, but I already am, because all these subscribers I haven't gotten from nothing. All these viewers I haven't gotten from nothing. And also I have a special announcement soon coming. T-shirts. That's it. That's all I'm going to say. T-shirts. I'm probably going to make apparel and other goodies for Audible Gaming, so be on the lookout for that, guys. Alright, so that's about it for the debut part of Bangladesh. Dominion of Bangladesh. Yes. Subscribe, like, thank you so much, guys, and I'll see you next time.